Right then, it's part two of the Honda C70 restoration. And yesterday it was absolutely peeing it down all day, and today it's not the best, but it's brightened up a bit and it's not raining in beautiful England. So yeah, you've seen the part one, you've seen what we did yesterday. Today, I'm gonna get the engine on the bench. I'm gonna take the head off, take the barrel off, regrinding the valves. Oh, builders next door. Jesus. Right, they've shut up. I regrind the valves in, and just do the best I can with the barrel, and then hopefully put it back together and have a nice bit of compression, nice little tight little motor, as tight as we can get it anyway for a 15,000 mile motor. And then eventually when we put it in, it should hopefully run like a Swiss watch. So yeah, let's go. Right then, well, I've got it on the bench, Black & Decker bench, and I've realised yesterday, I've undone a few little bits. I took the cover off here for like the cam chain and all that there, and I've realised these are the head bolts here. Yeah, so obviously that cover is on top here, and I just thought they were just four bolts just for the cover, but I've realised that they are obviously long bolts which must go all the way down here. And they're the head bolts, so when I put it back together, I'm going to have to torque them up. I've loosened the rockers up a bit, because I'm going to obviously readjust everything. Once I've got a new head gasket, new bottom gasket, everything's going to be readjusted. Cut the valves in, and just get it as best I possibly can. Hopefully there's no damage in there as well, because really, I don't know what it's like inside. I've never heard it run. The engine's been out since I bought it. So yeah, fingers crossed, it's going to be fine. So yeah, anyway, let's get stuck in. Shouldn't be too hard. It's going to take a few minutes. Have a look inside. Let's go. Well, I'm in there. Wasn't too difficult. Just undid the cam chain, three bolts. And as soon as that came free, because when I turned the engine the way around, it just dropped off. So as soon as that came free, this little sort of cog here, it just comes straight off. I didn't mention before, I have got it at top dead centre, it's like lined up T, and then there's like a zero at the bottom of this cog, which is lining up as well. So I'm presuming it's top dead centre. So yeah, the piston is at the top, so it's definitely top dead centre. And it's in quite good condition by the looks of it. The valves are absolutely caked in carbon. You can see there. So that'll be all cleaned off. They're going to recut these in. And we'll clean all this up. You know, it should hopefully run like a good one. Yep, so let's have a look at the piston. Let's take this off. Gently take this off. That's obviously a runner for the chain. It doesn't have a chain tensioner, but that does tension it. It's just one setting. If you put the bolt through, one setting for the chain by the looks of it. Remember, I don't really know what I'm doing. I've not worked on one of these before, so I'm just sort of learning as I go along. But they're not complicated, are they? Probably the easiest thing to start on. It'd be great for youngsters who want to start rebuilding engines and stuff. So if you're like a 13 year old or something, you want to get into it, maybe go and buy one of these, or even pit bikes, pretty much the same engine. Start with them, you can get hold of them easy enough. These are quite hard to get hold of, obviously. So this should wobble off, unless there's another screw on there, which I don't think there is. It should pull off, sure it does. Just prefer to pull it and get a screwdriver on it. That's it. Look at that. Move that so you can see a bit better. There you go. Hopefully this piston's gonna be in good nick. Oh, 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 look at that. Oh, 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 oh. Washer come off there. I don't know where that went from. We'll find out. Come on there, I think. So yeah, that piston looks in good condition. It's obviously brown. We can soon clean that. So yeah, all good. Barrel, nice, smooth, no scrapes, no scratches, no gouges. So yeah, all in all, happy with that. So I'll get up cleaning all this and then get it all back together. Right then, obviously, heads off. Been cleaning it all, you might have seen it on the time lapse. I've got an engineer's parallel here. It's perfectly straight, engineer's parallel. I've got some 600s wet and dry on that, and I've just been sort of cleaning it up with oil. And also cleaning up with that, which is a little bit of a razor blade on it. They're coming up quite clean, but I'm thinking, how do we get these cams out? Obviously the rockers are held in by this sort of rod here. But I've had a bit of a look. I've turned my head torch on and had a look down, and it looks like there's a little thread there, which makes sense because you can't knock them out from this side. There's nothing to knock them out on. So let's just see if it'll come out. Look at that. That winds in. Honestly, I've not tried this. Ta-da! Oh, look at that! Hey, flipping good old Honda, eh? Who'd have thought it? Bloody hell. Look at that. Oh yeah, second one. Doesn't really matter too much, they get mixed up. Well, I'll put them in here so they don't get mixed up. We're back in at the same end. So these rockers should pull off. Did one rocker. So obviously that is inlet rocker. So leave that at inlet end. So this is inlet end. That's exhaust end. So that's the exhaust rocker. We don't want to get them mixed up. They might be interchangeable, I don't know, but I'll try not to get them mixed up. Right, now for the cam. Just pull straight out, I should imagine. No, maybe not. Maybe it goes the other way. Yay, there's the cam. I've got that little beauty. Little cam. In very, very, very good condition. The head probably didn't really need to come off. Probably run absolutely perfect, but I've took it off now anyway. And at least I can clean the valves. But I've decided I'm gonna leave the piston in. I'm not gonna upset the circlips, because I haven't got any spare circlips, so I don't want to upset them. Because really, circlips, you should only use them once. Because obviously once you've took them out, they lose their springiness. And if they come out, I mean, the circlips on the grudging pin on the piston off the little end, if they come out, big problems. Yeah, very common on two strokes. They come loose and they cause disaster in your engine. So yeah, I don't want any of that, so I'm going to just leave it alone. So there's that. Anyway, very easy to know which way around that goes, because obviously you've got the screws for the cog on this side for the cam chain, and then this side. I have took a photograph of that, so I know how it goes. I have to line the timing marks up again, which surely can't be hard on a little tiny bike like this. So now we've got to try and get these valves out, so we can clean them up and reseat them, which is the main reason why I've stripped it all down, really. So yeah, it should run like a good one. I probably didn't need to strip it down, but it might have wasted my time, but I don't mind. Never mind, at least we know it's good. But I was looking in here, like we were saying before, there's no ridges, no scrapes, no nothing, but you can see where it's sat, because it is nearly 50 years old. You can see where the piston's sat, and it's just sort of, it'd be hard to see on camera. You might be able to see it, not too sure. Yeah, but you can't feel any ridges, but you can see where it's sat for years and years and years. Since like the last tax disc on it, when I put it in on DVLA, it said not taxed since 1982. So it's like, bloody hell, it's a 1976 bike. But I don't think it'll make any difference. So I'm just saying, you can see where the piston's been sat for decades, but I'm not moving. But should be fine. So yeah. Right. Let's get these valves out.
Should be fine, should be fine.
Not sure this will finger fit it. It's for cars, really. Jesus. Might not work. We'll see. We'll soon find out, won't we? Sure, we can put something in there to make it work, can't we? Yeah, yeah, of course can. If I can't get these out, I'm going to be disappointed. Never going to work. Never, ever, ever, ever going to work. No. I need a miniature valve clamp of some sort. Right, I'm thinking I'm going to go for the socket method. Socket. Will that even fit in there? Won't even go in. Jesus. I just can't get the valves out. I haven't got the right tool. I haven't got a miniature valve compressor, which is what you need. I don't think I can do it. I think I might just clean the valves up, get rid of these carbon deposits, and just hope for the best. I really wanted to cut them in though. I really wanted to recut them in, which will improve compression a little bit. So yeah, gutted. Right, I've just had a bit of a think and I thought you're giving up too easy here. So I found that and I found that. That's a bit of a spacer there. Yeah, just cut that out. So that should compress it. And I did have a bit of a go. You can actually press the springs in by hand, just pushing on it. They're not strong. It's only a flipping C70. You know, you can actually press them in and out. So I'm thinking now, will this work? Dun dun dun. So this is plastic. You probably won't use that on a car, but on this it probably, it might work. You never know. You never know, really, do you? You never know. Might not work. I think it would, but the actual tube of use is not long enough. Blimey. But I'll do welding them together. Bit good to weld to though, so you snap on sockets really. It'd be better if you cut the snap on socket out, but not when we're doing that. Clamped it. Should be able to get them out. Where's my magnet? Where's my magnet? Tiny, tiny, tiny telescopic magnet. Will it work? Yes, one out. Come on. My little bugger. Hey, two out. Yes. Keep them safe. That's the exhaust side. Ugh. Ta-da! There we go. There's the spring. There's two springs. Here comes the exhaust valve. Ta-da! Yes! Yes! You can clean that properly now.
Right then, well, I succeeded with both valves in the end, and I have managed to grind them in, but I've just done the best job I can, really, because this here, this little thing, didn't really want to stick to the valves all that well, so I have ground them in, but not the best I would have liked. And I'm just cleaning this surface here on the engine. I've packed tissue in here, so I obviously don't want bits of gasket getting in the engine. Clean these surfaces best I can, and yeah, it's getting there, and it's looking like it's going to be ready to put back together. I did think I wanted to put valve stem seals in here, but I've realised there's no valve stem seals in there. I've chipped away at a lot of this carbon, but it's so thick, you can't really do anything else. I've heard that walnut shells are the best, but I haven't got any walnut shells, any way of blasting it. I could probably send it away and get it clean professionally, but I'm just doing it as best I can. And I'm not touching the piston, like I said. All them rings are nice and free. I don't think I need to touch it. I'll make it worse than it is. Just leave it as it is. And thinking about it, I probably could have got away with actually not removing this cylinder head, but anyway, I've done it now. So yeah, just gonna have to hope and pray that this gasket kit is gonna work, because it's high level. There's a gasket there, and there's a little bit of a bend there, which was on when I got it, which isn't good. But yeah, it should hopefully work. But if not, there's another one. I have got another one here. Was that? Yeah. So yeah, get it back together in a minute, and hopefully we'll have lots of compression. Right then, let's see how this barrel goes on. So I put the new gasket on. You can see the blue gasket there. Obviously the surface is all nice and clean. Let's just see if it slides on nicely. I've blown it all out with the airline, so it's all nice and clean. I've put a little rubber on at the bottom there. I've used the original rubbers because I'm thinking they're probably better than the eye level ones. Little rubber there, you've got to remember that. Going in. Got that chain through. Come on, little bugger. See that timing mark? It's still lined up. When I took it apart before, is the rubber still in there? Has it fell out? Nope, the rubber is still in there. So we'll get gravity on its side, I think. Double check that rubber's there. Can't see all that well. Yes, it's there. And when this goes, oh, that's pushed the timing mark out, hasn't it? Didn't want to do that really. So as this goes down, it'll push it into position. There you go. How about that then? It's alright to me that. Oh yeah! And the timing mark back up. The T, the top dead centre. There it is. There. Right, well that's alright. Nice and easy. Right, let's try and get these valves back in. Right. So that side, nearest to you, is the exhaust side. This is here. It's quite clean now. Cleaned it with a grinder, a flap disc, a worn out flap disc. That carbon deposit would not come off. I've done my best around the back and I've obviously recut it in a little bit. Not a great deal, but yeah. I think these springs, inside spring goes any way round. There's no particular way round for them. Goes on there, like that. Top bit. And then two little collets, which are in here. They are tiny little things, you don't be losing them. Because I definitely haven't got any more. Well, I might have actually, because I've got a spare engine. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Can I actually get these collets in? That's the thing. Oh God. This is going to be fun, isn't it? Oh, Jesus. Oh, no. Oh, no. Right, it's going to be virtually impossible, isn't it? Isn't it? You gotta laugh, you gotta laugh, you gotta laugh, you gotta stay happy, man. Got it. Right, flyers. Could try the magnet. Could try. It's whether it'll drop. Magnet and pliers. Magnet and pliers. Magnet and pliers. Well, there's one gone in. I'm too sure if you can see that or not. It is a little bit sort of scary. Oh, it's come out. Around the back. It's come out. In. If you hope so. Yes! Oh! Oh! Yeah! There you go, you can see that. See where it's in. Bloody hell, eh? Right, didn't film the other one putting it in, but just coming to the end of it now. And it's in there perfectly. And I think if I release this now, pretty sure it'll grip. Yes. 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 Ooh. Both in. Looking pretty clean and nice under there. A lot less carbon, still a bit of carbon obviously, but I couldn't get it all off. So yeah, quite happy with that.
Bloody hell, seems tight for a little 6 millis. Bloody hell.
Inch pounds, foot pounds, 10. 6. Oh, that's 10 there. Shit, that's why. That's 10 there. 9, 8. Shit. Wasn't set right. Oh dear. That's it now. Oh, fuck.
Oh yeah. You can feel it. There it is. Oh yeah, I've got plenty. You can't hear it, but you can feel it right there. Just as that timing mark lines up, more compression. Plenty of compression. Oh, brilliant. Woohoo!
Yeah, that's it for the head anyway. really, really happy with that. Very, very fiddly. But yeah, got there in the end. It's got loads of compression, which I'll show you in a minute. Torqued up the head bolts, torqued up the bolts on the cog for the chain, and a thread locks them. It's got one falling off, and yeah, great little design these. I absolutely love this engine. They're so good, so simple and so good. But yeah, I'll just show you, or let you try and let you hear the compression.
Yeah, listen to this. Yep, so fine. There's it's that top dead centre already. So line the T up. So just go before that then. Yeah. Oh. Yeah. Go that way. Where? What? So you got right. Oh, compression stroke. There it is. That's compression stroke. And then it'll suck. Oh, it's sucking. Yeah? Compression stroke. Oh. There you go, that's better. I'm happy with that anyway. You get the drift. Where's the T? There it is. So yeah. Yeah, well that's it, part two's done. Part three hopefully we'll be doing this clutch. Possibly getting the engine in if the engine mounts are turned up. I've ordered a manifold for this in the end. It's got like a little bit of a heat plate on it. I have found some gaskets in the gasket set, so we don't need to make one of them, which we were saying in part one. Yeah, it's all good. I'm very confident. I think once it goes back together, it's points, so there's no chance of a CDI going down or anything like that. So it should just start sparking straight away, and it hopefully should run like a Swiss watch. Like I said at the beginning. That's it. Part two. Thank you very much. See ya.